British Prime Minister Boris Johnson is considering options to get on with Brexit before the October deadline amid a political deadlock in Parliament. One America's Kristian Rouz reviews the possible ways out.
If Boris Johnson decides that he wants to go for a clean break Brexit, we will work together with him.
Brexit Party leader Nigel Farage offers an alliance to Prime Minister Boris Johnson amid a conflict between his Conservative cabinet and Parliament over the future EU relations. In an interview Thursday, Farage said he has more than 600 Parliament candidates across the country ready for a snap election and vowed to defeat the Labour Party in a landslide. His remarks come just months after the Brexit Party took the majority of UK votes in this year's elections to the EU Parliament.
We voted to leave, didn't we? It wasn't conditional. We didn't vote for a deal. We voted to leave. It's as simple as that. The Labour Party thinks that you are stupid. The Labour Party thinks they know better.
Farage's offer comes as Johnson faces an opposition-proposed bill to block a no-deal Brexit. The bill, currently under review in the House of Lords, would compel the Prime Minister to seek yet another extension of a Brexit deadline from the EU, something Johnson has categorically refused to do.
Yes.
And sorry. And would you
I'd rather be dead in a ditch.
According to reports, the Lords are expected to approve the bill by Friday night and send it back to Commons for a final vote on Monday, after which it would likely become law. But many members of the upper chamber are not convinced. They say a risky no-deal Brexit is a better option than handing the UK sovereignty back to the EU.
This bill is, I hope, one of the final acts of a House of Commons which has proved itself manifestly incapable of meeting the challenges in front of it. I urge your lordships to reject it.
In this light, Johnson faces choices of how to enforce a no-deal Brexit going forward. Analysts say if the bill blocking no-deal becomes law, the Labour would likely agree to hold a snap election in mid-October. If Tories and Brexit Party win a majority in Parliament, they would have a few days to repeal that law and get on with Brexit.
I do everything I possibly can to make sure that this country comes out of the EU on October the 31st.
Another option, Johnson could call a motion of no confidence in his own cabinet Monday or even resign to force a snap election in October. Polls suggest Tories and the Brexit Party would likely win more than 50% of the vote between them, making Farage's latest proposal quite viable.
But I do share the view of growing numbers of people in this country that we must get on with Brexit. And months or even years of delay in Brexit Day, which I think this bill accommodates, will make matters worse, not better.
Johnson says one way or another, the UK will leave the EU this year, which, even at the price of his resignation, would propel Boris to the stunning heights of British politics, likely landing him back into the Prime Minister's seat. Kristian Rouz, One America News.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.